Hello! Welcome back to Record Keeper. Today, we have an FF7 event. It's Kate Sith. You know, for as much as I harp on Final Fantasy VII for being overwrought, it's one of my better realms, so nah, I don't mind it being around. Alright. All this stuff launched early, this event, and I just hadn't gotten around to it because I'm a man of habit. But let's get into shit anyway. So first up we have, this is the pagoda fight, so you get the four dudes together. You just gotta slow one of them. And then you got Godo, and who you also have to slow. These are... I don't think they're super threatening. They just have to stack a lot of AoE for the first fight. And then Godo really isn't too much, I don't think. Which is exactly what I did. I'm bringing Tempo Flurry for slow against my better judgment. I should probably just bring a Sloga, but it didn't really fit into my party setup. And then everything else is just built to win the fight. Some of the scarier moves are kind of physical based, so that's why I brought the power breakdown or a magic breakdown or anything like that. I'm coming through alright, yeah? Good. And then we're gonna grab this, because I like me regen and haste. Also covers the defense that I'm not protecting, so 10 out of 10. Everybody wins. There we go. Alright, let's see how this goes. Now, we do have to land this slow, which might be a little annoying. We pretty much have to hold off on everybody else until we can land that slow on somebody. Oh, hey. Go figure. Now, the damage they put out is pretty significant, actually. And also, they do cast party-wide reflex, so you don't want to bank on single-target magic. But, if you have decently leveled hones, they go down pretty fast. They might not even make it two turns. Well, that was fun. Keep this going. We're gonna keep the tempo flurries going with Zach because we do want that slow to get on there. And we'll pretty much have to hold back at the end if that slow never lands. Yeah, that Valforb really did work in that last fight. Still kind of thinking about 16,000 damage. Ah, there's the slow. Okay, now I can go 100% all out. Yeah, this boss rush oddly didn't seem that hard. Now, mind you, Godo does have a lot of weird tricks, but if you have AoE, the trio fight isn't really that big of a deal. And if you have good single target, you can take down Godo pretty fast. It's pretty much getting that slow that is the big thing. I was during thinking about the ultimate Godo fight that we had. I miss those days of simpler ultimates. It was a good time. That's a fight. Okay. I'm actually going to step out of the... you know what, yeah. Step out of the event very fast. I want to level break Yuffie immediately. Huh. That's interesting materia. Similar to the other one we have, the Flash Blade. The one that we got from Lightning. I want to say it was called Flash Blade. Okay, so the setup's going to change a little bit, but the party structure is going to stay the same. Because here... we have Rude, who actually hits really hard with magic attacks. Not so much in the defense, or you know what I mean. I was just thinking about something. Is Dispel white magic? I think Dispel is white magic. It is. Oh, balls. Because he does cast Shell on himself right at the start. only white one. I really want that Shelga, though. Let's see what Roaming Warriors we get. This is Divine Guardian. Two Divine Guardians. And we'll be fine. Okay. Yeah, a little bit worried that won't do a lot of damage to... with the, jeez, I'm having a brain fart. Won't do a lot of damage with everything up, but... we'll see. Well, there's the slow, which is exactly kind of what I wanted. Alright, let's see... well, actually, he didn't get the energy ray up, or the end barrier. Ooh, that's actually not going to do that much damage once he gets end barrier up. Oh well. We'll be fine. Especially once we're regenning. Alright, let's see how much this does. Ah, 6,000 still fine. And with full break, it'll be even more damage. So Smoke Bullet is a very annoying ability. This has a chance to blind and sleep. As such, I've actually equipped both the melee people with accessories that block blind. Because that's super annoying. And as always, Swift whack to the head with a staff is the best way to get rid of sleep. The attacks from the soldiers do actually hit pretty hard, though. Maybe a Protectka, not a bad idea. But I mean, also in like another sense, if you're dealing enough damage AoE, they're not much of a concern. Because eventually they will just be gone and be a non-factor. Though everybody did get pretty low before that happened. I was gonna refresh everything, but I guess we should just go for it. We still have the haste, and we still have the Shelga. We still have the regen. That's really all we need. This should be a fight right here. Maybe the next move. Yeah, it's the next one. Probably a Protectia or a Sentinel Grimoire, just be careful. You know, no reason to be risky with it. Okay. Some good orbs though to refresh out all the junk I've been using. Alright. Ancient Memories is of course Demon Gate. As you get him down, he uses bunch of abilities, like a party-wide, really hard-hitting ability, Demon Rush. And then, if the battle goes on for too long, he uses Petrify Eye. But he can be slowed, which gives you more time. And he's also all melee-based. And also can be just realized what I did here. Aside from being all melee based, and being able to slow it and being able to do all that, you can also sap him. Yes, this is good now. Hoping for... Yes! Good, Hand of the Emperor. So that's actually the general idea. Yuffie's gonna sap. Zidane's gonna slow. And then everybody else is just gonna be doing damage. Or increasing damage. Okay. Right? I know. We don't have haste, so we're not going to be going super fast, but we do have a lot of other stuff. Decking out our repertoire. And there's the slow. Nice. Means now I can just go wild. See how much this does. That still did pretty decent damage. What was that? It's with power breakdown. Jesus. This is like, there's actually a lot on the boss right now. There's power breakdown. There's Hand of the Emperor. There's full break. There's Protectica. And that still did a lot of damage. Though my team is actually pretty tanky, I can kind of take those hits. That's the last one. Now it's just a matter of bursting the boss down. Thief's Revenge. Such a good ability. I don't regret honing that to rank 3 at all. Oh. I'm not sure why that did so much damage. Maybe this guy just actually hits pretty hard. Good thing to remember. I guess I got a little lucky. Ooh. That was a major orb. Okay, the ultimate. Let's just keep this train moving. Actually, I'm going to take a hot second and check something on my phone. Alright, so it's carry armor. So things to note, carry armor's main body, if it's hit with damage before the arms are destroyed, will grab somebody. Also, you have to do so much damage to an arm in order for them to be freed. Carry armor itself only uses magic attacks, so magic breakdown and shell are extremely useful, and once the arms are destroyed, it gains a lightning weakness. Now, for the setup. Okay. So the general strategy here actually is turn one, get all the defenses up, right? And then turn two, first action. Will actually be a magic breakdown from red, but then second action will be Valfor from Terra. That's going to hit the body and cause the counterattacks. But hopefully somebody that's not Terra gets grabbed, because then we'll be able to focus on AoEing, doing a lot of damage to the sides and everything. And that should add up. Shrugging. The idea here is that by doing this, you actually eliminate Carry Armor's physical attacks. I don't know how this is going to work in execution. I'm kind of basing this off of one video I saw. But, kind of really shrugging on this. I forgot to get stats. Well, let's get this one for now. Yeah, the ultimate fights for this event are kind of a test of how well have you honed your abilities, and do you have what it takes to last for these fights, because, so this boss effectively has like 360,000 health. And no, the app froze. That was interesting. That's never happened before. The boss essentially has 360,000 health, which is a lot. It's a lot to break through. Most strategies that I've seen involve, you know, taking down one arm, taking down the other arm, all the while, like, weathering the attacks. But that requires to have a lot of shit. So, we'll see if this works. I think this'll work. Ah, fuck it, let's just see. I'll probably have to regroup, but, whatever. There is a bit of RNG base into this strat, but it's also, overall, doesn't require that much hones, so that's why I like it. Yeah, and you always get hit by that first Lapis Laser, which does a lot of damage. And then you need two physical attacks. So, alright, and now we have protections up. That's better. Alright, let's see who gets grabbed. Now, if you have Shout, perfectly viable strategy to just go for each arm. Alright, that's good. That's fine. Okay. Now we just need to get the healing. Can't do physical attacks anymore, so we're just going to be eating Lapis Lasers. That is until the we do enough damage to the arms for allies to be free. And we once again are rolling the dice. Yeah, it should be noted that the boss is extremely fast. Alright, let's see what we get here. Alright. Good. Now, this is where it's going to get a bit iffy, because our Sentinel Grimoire is a little low, probably be wearing off soon. I'm doing this very preemptively. You know what? She's done most of the work that she needed to do. That's fine. We're actually going to move to single target, just to not risk... Oh, Terra's not getting Sentinel Grimoire because she was grabbed? I was not aware of that. Shit. She'll be fine. The real problem is I need to get haste back up. See, I'm starting to really get punished by the Lapis Laser. Perfect. Worth the body. Don't say, okay, you won just yet. I don't want to jump to conclusions here. I know it gets easier in the second half, but... Look, I'm a scaredy baby, alright? Yeah, because that laser gets stronger too. Full break will make it a little bit easier, but Yeah, this is it. This is the home stretch. We're in the DPS race right here. Yeah, just keep using those single targets. Just fuck it. You hate Cloud. Go for Cloud. Sometimes I'm like, I can't tell if it's speed one or if haste wore off. Or if Sentinel Grimoire wore off like it just did. This is tight. Oh, I think I got it though. Whew! AoE! You need a little bit of luck, but AoE I think is the way to go. Terra wasn't grabbed twice, and that paid off. Nice. Also, only one metal loss for damage. Now for the rougher stuff. What? Oh. Oh, okay, it's that stuff because they added Shantotto. I haven't got any of this yet. One sec. Oh. I guess I didn't read the announcement well enough. Ah, here we go. Tomorrow, okay. All right, that's for later though. This shit right here. So the boss rush is an arena, or the boss rush. The ultimate plus is a boss rush arena. Reduce Yin Yang's magic, reduce Ultimate Chimera's attack, reduce Proud Clad's attack. So. They all do their own shit. The Yin Yangs have a good bit of magic to them. Ultimate Chimera has a very vicious physical attack. And Jammer has... Jammer. It's Jammer. Or not Jammer. Proud Clad. Clad. You definitely need Protect Gun Shelga. We'll get to it. First, the setup. So. We'll talk about it once we get in there. Oh, come on. I need a shout. I could have used the ultimate. So, alright. Yeah, alright. So, the general idea is AoE for the first fight, DPS the second fight, and then try and save as much as you have for the final one. And in the final one, you actually don't want to destroy the jammer. Because when you do, Proud Claude actually becomes way more vicious. A lot of people that I've talked to, even somebody who did a default break strategy, didn't destroy the jammer. It just becomes way more vicious if you actually take out the jammer. Come on. I was kind of hoping with the dungeon update we would get that little thing that Japan just got, which is lets them refresh their roaming warriors just with a button, because that's real nice, and I wish Global had that immediately. Like, they announced it for Japan, and I was like, I want that. Come on. There we go. Oh, nice. That's some high-ass mind. So, Sephiroth is our AoE. I'm sorry, I'm having a brain fart. Sephiroth is the AoE. Everybody else is kind of damaged, and they're going to spread theirs out. In the first phase, Red and Zach are going to be bouncing back and forth. And Igris is going to throw out some spell blades. In phase 2, we DPS as fast as we can. Same thing with phase 3. That's it. It's not overly complex, really. This fight is a straight set of... Can I rename in here? Good. I renamed these wrong. Alright, I named these wrong. This fight is just a straight hone check. Like, have you been working on your abilities, or have you been relying on stupid strategies? Well, not stupid strategy. I should never call a strategy stupid. But like a low hone strategy. Okay, and also another thing is everybody has equipped damage boosting record materia because they're probably going to hit the damage cap. Now, even though I'm not using many 5-star weapons, my armor is pretty good, so take that into account. I'm trying to figure out how to start this fight off. Already really nervous. See, getting those first couple of breaks out are what's extremely rough. Oh, I should have held his move. Then we lost haste already. Huh. They're dishing way more damage than I would have thought, considering somebody did this default break. I think Protect wore off. Oh, that's a lucky miss. I feel as though as I've been lied to. Alright, so Sephiroth. Yeah, there goes Shout. We'll talk after this attempt. I think what it boils down to is I used Shout early, maybe. Oh, here comes the good shit. Yeah, I think this is... Let's not keep this going. So I know one thing, and that's that haste ran out and I used shout to refresh it. That's a no. Don't do that. What I should have done instead was this order right here. Because now shout's gonna go off second, which is gonna make it last a bit longer. Are you kidding? Magic attacks are doing so much damage to me. I need that magic. At least in the second fight. Oh wait, no they weren't. What am I kidding? Give me a moment. I still want to try it this way. Oh, piss. I didn't need to do that. It's fine. We'll just push it to four uses. Whew. See, now this is a better time to use this. Okay. Jesus Christ. Ah, piss. Oh, this is gonna do a lot of damage. Yeah, that's the end of that. We need to regroup. Fuck. What if... Okay. Oh, wait.
I'm guessing your message meant to say Discord?
Yeah.
Righto. So, I think this team is actually pretty close to being able to do it without the SG. Just needs a little bit more oomph.
I just noticed that up top had the wrong materia.
I mean, that's going to be a big difference, because 20%, yeah, that's big on Zach. You can probably put Dragon's Determination on Grias.
No.
Why?
Attack cap. Like, they're hitting the attack cap.
Soft cap?
Yeah.
I mean, even if they're hitting the cap, she's still probably getting a bigger boost out of it than the other way.
You think that, except, like, on Kuja, when I switched them over to the 20%, they were doing more damage.
I hate this game.
Okay.
Is there any other weaponry you can throw on? Or are they already, like, capped out on best gear?
They're already kind of capped out. So I'm thinking a thing. Dismissal, right?
Yes.
It should be really good.
Uh-huh.
But what if instead that was power breakdown, armor breakdown?
You mean armor break?
Down.
Can Zach use armor breakdown?
No, but I bring a different person.
Oh, I see what you're talking about. So you're talking about, like, Vaughn?
I was thinking Ramza.
Oh, Ramza.
Or whoever has higher defenses. No, I'm not
actually,
using my shout.
Honestly, can you go back to that group?
Yeah.
The screen there, sorry. Kind of think that Zach's okay. You just need to shift the magic break on red to armor breakdown. Because once you get past the first... I know, hear me out on this. Once you get past the first two, the only magic attack is the big shot. And, I mean, that's bad, but that's survivable if you're at, like...
Yeah, but the first two were what were messing me up.
Well, the idea is that you only have one stamina use here, so I was just suggesting that maybe try it out to see how it goes. But you definitely need to hone up, like, Sephiroth's Dark Bargain, or whatever the heck that thing is.
I don't have the orbs. I really do not have the orbs.
You can't even break down, like, 5 stars for it?
I could.
You should. At least get it up to a 6, because an extra 2 hits is huge.
Alright, what do I need? The thing is, I think it uses power as well. I'll have to see.
You'll be fine.
I only need to break one. The thing is, I was actually thinking of honing power breakdown.
Oh, up to 10 uses?
Mm-hmm.
So you'd be bringing in, like, Ramza, like you said?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think having Zach with that rush assault is actually a bigger thing for you.
Okay.
You have Shout on and an armor breakdown, or at least an armor break, be okay.
Because the dismissal really wasn't doing that much for me.
Yeah, switch the dismissal over to an armor break, and I think that'd be okay. I like dismissal just because it can save you a little bit of damage there, especially on a Chimera.
Well, okay, here's a better thought. What if we just switch Thundaga Blade to armor break?
It might not be a bad idea. I'd keep the dismissal that way. I mean, she doesn't have a lightning booster on, does she?
No.
Okay, then yeah, that might not be a terrible idea.
You didn't really indicate that the damage was still really high in this fight.
I got really lucky. I think I mentioned that when I was talking about that Chimera, that he used his magic attack more than his physical attacks. And if he uses his magical attack, you just kind of laugh because it's maybe 2,000 damage as opposed to his physical attack, which is a combined about 5,000 damage. So he only got off about 4 to 5 rounds worth of attacks because I blew him up because I was saving my breaks for him. And then I was able to get through, the guy at the end because he used a lot of materia jammers. You can do this fight without having Shout plus a wall, but it becomes much more of an RNG fest because there's just so many things that like have to go your way. The first two guys have to not use their AoE physical attack too many times. You have to pray that Chimera doesn't decide just to use Rake every round. He uses Freeze every so often. And then in the last fight, you have to hope that he doesn't use his laser too many things.
Like I think
he uses his punch or the wrist laser.
Yeah, I think this will be a good experimentation. Oh, right, I was going to switch power and... See, if I switch this to power breakdown, I have less uses on red. You see where I'm coming from there? Hello?
Oh, sorry, yeah, sorry. I just realized I've been muted for a little bit.
Huh.
So, I think an armor breakdown or an armor break on Agrius is okay. I think the magic breakdown on red is okay. What you need more is damage than anything else, just because you're running out of steam at the end. So I try it just with a new armor break. And also, by the way, does red get more damage out of using either of his hairpins rather than that 6-star glove you got there?
A little bit. I think I might use some better weapons.
Yeah, I think you might need to start doing that. Because one of the first things I said when I talked about this fight is you need a lot of FF7 gear in order to be able to do this without wall plus shout. I don't have that, but I have a lot of super soul breaks, which made it a little bit easier. Oh yeah, you can definitely crank up the damage here a little bit.
And this lets me switch him back to that sword materia.
Yepers, what was he using before? Oh, a katana.
He was using the katana. He was using a katana with the sword one, so this will actually increase his damage 20%, oddly enough.
Yeah, well, funny how those things work out. You just passed it.
Yeah, I keep passing it because it's an 8.
One-eyed generals.
Yep.
So, the sad thing is you might have been able to do it just with an extra 20% damage on Zach.
Possibly. But
I think this is better. I don't think you need to... I think you should try to see how this goes and then go from there.
Yeah. It's one of those things that sometimes you just sit there and think and be like, I could be done.
I understand. Well, the biggest thing about this fight is that Zach's getting a 40-point attack boost, and the other two are getting about 15 points each. And Zach's also getting a 20% attack boost on top of his... or not attack boost, damage boost on top of that attack boost, so he's going to be hitting a hell of a lot harder. Oh, look at them shouts.
The only thing is I lost that sweet, sweet 300.
Did you at least save that?
It was one of my people.
Okay. Yeah, that's... Of course Tarzan does that.
Yeah.
But okay. The other thing is, you're not really using these shouts for the... haste. You're using it for the damage thing, because you got red 13 for the haste.
Yeah, but... Yeah.
That extra 4 seconds is going to hurt too much. Probably. Maybe.
Alright. Well, I'm going to try again.
Good luck.
I'll give this a couple of attempts, and if this doesn't work, I'm just going to go in with a native shout. This does kind of show that this is possible, though, which is what I'm aiming for. Whoops. I did it again. I reversed the fucking pictures. Okay. Oof. I'm thinking really hard right now, sorry. Always make sure that shout comes second, because what am I saying? That's not even a general strategy thing. I debuffed the same one twice. We call this playing well, that TXT. Oh, that's a reset. Just screams internally. Yeah, they have AoE magic. They have a single target and an AoE of both. Now, the nice thing about Dark Bargain is it does actually stack with Shout. Gives us a nice advantage there. Pretty much we want them to keep doing their single target attacks. If we can keep that coming in, we can get a nice advantage on them. Only I had a... I don't know. They say if only I had like another AoE. Only we had that one that Japan has. This is almost like a joke. It's the amount of AoE. Jesus. Cross our fingers for not a lot of damage. Maybe. Please. Okay. That's not good. Gotta get that haste back up. Gotta get our damage back up. Gotta get our healing back up. While seemingly going better, not disagreeing with you, I'm scared. Whew. Those breaks off. Miss. Shelga. Fuck! Damn it. If I had Shelga up, that would have been fine. Like, fucking, when would I have refreshed it? Damn it. Shit. I need to calm down. I'm just really upset with myself. I mean, Crumb's right. This team can do it. I think, you know, we're showing that off at the very least. If this sort of drags on for a really long time, I might, swap out, do a Ramza with Wall, just because, you know, I really don't want to be here all night. You gotta quickly get your composure. That sucked. We were close. But calm yourself down. Lean back a bit. Actually a lot of health in this first fight here. I'm just sitting here thinking about it for a moment. Oh, that's not good. Anyone else? Agris, your health. I don't like it that low. Agrius? Sitting here thinking now. Agarius? There's actually an interesting little, like, pattern of how the attacks have to go out here. Sort of like a 1, 2, 3, 4 sort of thing going. 1, 2, 3. Yep. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe. If I have to regroup. That's not a bad idea, Chrome in the chat is suggesting putting the cat's bell on Selfie. Which is not necessarily a bad idea. Rakes. Jesus Christ, are you kidding me? Price for dismissal. All right. Amazing. Because we can't get three, right? All that healing is about to be gone. No materia jammer on you. Get you next turn. No, oh, shout wore off. Those misses, though. Yes! Yes! Get there! Yes! Doable. See, sometimes you have to know when your videos are going to cut out, and that's specifically the last line of a video. Just doable fade out. Huh. Yeah, that's fucking rough. Like I said, I have a friend who did it with all defaults. So, I'm gonna watch back his video and see, like, what the fuck he does. I think he just has really good synergy, is what it is. Which is pretty shitty when you say, hey look, I did it in all defaults, and it's like, okay, but your synergy is fucking amazing. Which, like, my synergy was really good, and I still almost died. That's a pretty good accessory. That's a really fucking good accessory. I might use that from now on, just as my straight healer equipment. But that's it for this week of Record Keeper. Next week is Final Fantasy 13 2. With a nightmare of an Ultimate Plus. I'll see you then.